Utba ibn Rabi'ah. You can think of Utba ibn Rabi'ah as the Sean Hannity of back in the day. Okay? Expert debater, very insulting to those who oppose him in public discourse. He was a negotiator on behalf of conflicting tribes. He was hired for that. He was a consultant, you could say, that would go in and make demands and get the thing done, you know? These are the kind of people that Quraysh, when they said this war of words, we're losing. So we got to get somebody who's really good at their words. Somebody really good at debate and discussion and negotiation. So they hired Utba. And they say, go Utba, you talk to Muhammad. He's sitting there, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Of course, they didn't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You go talk to him. You make some demands on him. Figure out what he wants. Humiliate him, by the way. We'll watch from a distance. Nowadays, we watch football games from a stadium or from the, you know, our couches on TV. This was their sport. To watch one want to go against the other in this debate, right? So they're watching from a distance. They don't want to get too close, but they're about to enjoy this matchup between Utba ibn Rabi'ah and who? Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Utba goes very insulting, extremely condescending. Ya Muhammad, what do you want? You want wealth? We'll give you money. You want women? We'll give you women. You want shared power? We'll give you some power too. What do you want? Make your demands. Now by already saying that, he is not judging the content of what Muhammad says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He never made any demands of money, nor of anything else. He is not judging anything but the intentions, the person. This is called character assassination. The best way you can dismantle somebody or somebody's credibility is that you attack their motives. Why are you really presenting this message? You must have some alternative agenda hiding underneath. Which is why you're talking this way. So he rats off, barks like a dog at the messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The messenger is listening carefully and silently, patiently. And when he's done in very small, very soft tones, the messenger says to him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "Afaraghta ya Aba Walid? Are you done? Are you finished?" He says, "Fine, your turn." The messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam, did nothing but recite Quran. He recites from Surah Fussilat. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم حميم First thing he says, it is a revelation, rough translation, of course I can't match what Allah says, but rough translation. It is something that has been set down from the exceedingly merciful, the constantly merciful. The intention, when the attack came from Utba, the idea was these are your words, and you're just trying to get something out of it. The first thing the Quran says in response is what? This is not my words, where are they from? There, you're not negotiating with me. Who are you debating right now? You're not fighting me, you're fighting Allah. These are his. It's a book. It's actually a book. Right now it's being presented in words, but where does it come from? Kitab. Fussilat ayat. Whose manifestations, whose demands have been made absolutely clear. Remember, he asked about demands, right? What do you want? Allah says the ayat are absolutely clear. The ayat make certain demands. Now, what are those demands in? Are they in your language? Arabic, Quran, Malaysian, you want to know what we want? You want to know what Allah wants? You want to know what the demands are? Here they are, they're coming. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla, He reveals the ayah Bashirun wa Nadir. This Quran came, it's two main functions. Bashir, you know what that means? Something that gives good news. It comes with good news. It's got a good proposition. Wa Nadira. And a warning. A threat. Wa Nadira. فأعرض أكثرهم لا يسمعون. But most of them ignored on purpose. إعراض is to ignore something on purpose. They don't even listen. And they are the ones who are actually not listening. They think you're not listening to them, but the real dumb, the real, you know, people incapable of hearing are those people over there. They're the ones that are not listening to them as well. So Allah is responding to his negotiation with Ayat al-Quran. And as the Ayat are being Utba started crying. Their expert negotiator, kafir, hater of Islam, insulter of the messengers of Allah. فعله الله. He uses Quran and he starts crying. He cries so much as the ayat go on and they get stronger and stronger in their wording. And he tries to grab the mouth of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, please stop. You can't take anymore. The Messenger kept on reciting sallallahu alayhi wa sallam until he reached the ayat of sallam. دَرَبُنَا دَرَبُنَا. He comes back, walks back from this debate. This expert negotiator of the Quraysh, who their hopes were lying in. And he comes back and they say, your face doesn't look the same that you left. It's not the face you left. And he comes back and says, whatever this man has to say, he will become an enormous event. Whatever this man has to say will become an enormous event. Now this is important, because the ayat of Quran, the ayat that the Messenger was reciting, we don't have time to go into all of them, but at least the last one. فَإِنَّ عَرَبُهُ. This is towards the end of the passage. فَإِنَّ عَرَبُهُ. And if they continue to ignore deliberately, if they've done so, فَقُلْ. Then you tell them. Now who's you? Muhammad. By the words, Utbah realizes he's not talking to Muhammad. Rather, Allah is not dignifying Utbah. Allah is telling the Messenger to tell him. Allah is not telling him directly. Allah could have said, أَنذَرْتُكُمْ, I'm warning you. He said, فَقُولْ أَنذَرْتُكُمْ. You tell him that I am warning all of you. All of you of what? صَاعِقَةً, a powerful explosion. مِثْلَفْ, صَاعِقَةِ عَادٍ بَثَمُ. Just like the explosion that occurred with Lut, Ad and Thamud. This is something the Arabs knew. They knew this had happened in the past. And now, Utbah sitting there just realized he has been issued a direct threat from Allah himself. From the words of the Messenger that had been given to him by Allah himself, he was overcome. He comes back and says, whatever this man has to say, I suggest you take it seriously. I consider Qumun Aman Ar-Rahim, he's soon going to become a huge event. They say to him, Saharak, he did magic on you too. He cast his spells on you too. He said, say what you will, it's not magic, but I'm not talking to him anymore. He gave up on the Messenger. I shared this with you for one reason, to illustrate a tragedy. And that tragedy is the disbelievers at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the believers shared one thing. They shared one thing. They were both overpowered by what? The Quran. قرآني نبض حياتي قرآني طهر ذاتي قرآني عصمة أمري قرآني طوق نجاتي قرآني نبض حياتي.